Hello guys, welcome to our channel, and in this video we'll be discussing and reviewing the radiology residency program in Kokilaben Dhirubhai Ambani Hospital, and we have two of the residents from that program.
Hi, I'm Dr. Shivika.
I'm Dr. Akhila, we're first year residents.
So Shivika and Akhila, welcome to this video, and can you tell us a general overview of this department? How many residents are there to be?
Okay, so we have two primary residents every year and two secondary residents every year. And a primary residency is a program for 3 years. Secondary residency is a program for 2 years. So therefore, in total, we have 6 primary residents and 4 secondary residents. Also, we have 2 senior residents or clinical associates in our department.
And how many consultants are there?
So if I go modality wise, for conventional radiography, we have 2 consultants. In ultrasound, we have 6 consultants, and they are sub-specialized in fetal medicine, musculoskeletal imaging, then Doppler imaging, women imaging. Then for cross-sectional, we have 5 consultants. They are also specialized in neuroimaging, musculoskeletal imaging and body imaging, to name a few. Then in intervention, we have 4 consultants for vascular intervention, neuro intervention and CT guided biopsies or diagnostic interventions.
So Dr. Akhila, coming to you, can you tell us more about the rotation among the postings?
Yeah, so once we start our work in this department as first year, the first 6 months will be posted in ultrasound and x-ray every alternate month. So after that, we start getting posted in CT and MR, and this usually happens by around January if we have joined by June. So CT MR postings will be there during second and third years, and in second year there will also be ultrasound and x-ray postings here and there. So basically by the end of 3 years we would have probably had around 10 postings each of CT and MR, and around 5 to 6 postings of ultrasound and x-rays. So apart from that, we will have around 15 days posting of intervention towards the end of third year.
So guys, can you tell us more about how are the duty timings like, and how many hours a day a resident is supposed to work, and also how many holidays a resident can get per year?
Yeah, so official timings are, in x-ray it's from 8 in the morning to 6 in the evening. In ultrasound, 8 to 7. In CT, 8 to 8. And MR, 8 to 9. So these are the official timings. We usually tend to stay back for long hours just to study and look at cases and stuff. And so about night duties, every 5th day we get a night duty. And every 5th Sunday we get a night duty. So the Sundays that we don't have duty, we are off, like proper offs. And Sundays are also clubbed with holidays. So Sunday and holiday will be together, one duty. And every 5th holiday will be the duty basically. So, and that will be a 36-hour shift. We will have no post-duty off.
And what about taking leaves? Does a resident who is coming from away gets to go to home periodically?
Yes. So we are officially given 30 days of leave, as most of you already know, 30 days of leave per year. It is not...
And it's followed in the department?
Yes, it is. The consultants are very reasonable, even seniors. In general, it's a great working environment. So we, for necessary reasons, we do get leave pretty easily.
That's a wonderful thing to know. Our viewers will be really happy to know about this. So tell us more about, in short, more about x-ray, ultrasound, CT and MRI exposure, and how's the reporting environment is for the residents.
Okay, so I'll go modality wise. When we are posted in x-ray, we also get to do fluoroscopy guided procedures. A resident is supposed to do all the procedures. Then when we are posted in ultrasound, we are supposed to start the scan first on any patient, and then a consultant will review that scan. Also, the consultant is going to tell us the right technique to perform the scan, and if we have missed a finding, the consultant is going to tell us about it. Then in CT and MRI, all the IPDs and emergencies are reported primarily by the resident, and then it is finalized by the consultant. and for OPDs all the history taking and monitoring is done by us. So the benefit of this is that we get to develop an approach towards a case, and also when we report the when we do the reporting for the first time and when it is rechecked by our consultant, then they tell us the mistakes that we have made. So they will call us, they will tell us, they'll discuss the case with us. So it's really very nice and very helpful for learning.
And also a really good part is that all of this is packs in packs. So the report that you make, the provisional report, is also going to be stored in the system, and the finalized report that the consultant will be making will be corrected in the same thing. So the next day, once it's finalized, you can just go have a look at your report and know exactly where you went wrong or where you could have changed the reporting language. So those kind of small things will add up to a lot.
And yeah, PACS is really great because you can see all the cases that have happened so far. So it's like a library, a radiology library for us. Whatever cases we want to see, whatever references we want to take, or whatever cases we want to take for our presentations, we can use it, of course, after saving patients' details and other things. And yeah, it's a very good way of learning.
Yeah, and also the previous imaging of the patient, for example, if you want to compare the progression or how the patient is improving after disease, so it will help out a lot.
All right. Okay, can you guys specifically comment on how many X-ray procedures or CT-guided biopsies, fluoroscopy you guys get to do as a freehand?
Yeah, so intervention as a posting dedicatedly is given by the end of the third year. So that's around 15 days posting that we get. But apart from that, the while we are posted in each of these departments, for example, if I am posted in ultrasound right now, if I do show the interest, I will be given free hand for ultrasound guided procedures. So the same thing applies to CT also. And also, since our center deals a lot with stroke cases and neuro interventions and all that, even at say one of our duties we get a stroke for whom mechanical thrombectomy is planned, we can go have a look at the entire procedure. So a good kind of hands-on plus observer experience is there.
That's wonderful. Can you guys talk about how is the obstetric ultrasound situation at this place, and also in terms of, do you guys get to do Doppler scans?
Okay, so for obstetric scans, it's a limitation for all the DNB institutes because the number of cases are very less as compared to the government. But having said that, we get enough exposure, we learn the basics of obstetrics in these 3 years. And also, if you want to do fellowships and in fetal medicine, there are a lot of options available even after our post graduations. Dopplers, yes, we get to do Dopplers during our calls, and also if we are posted in ultrasound, portable scans are there. So if we show special interest, then we can get to do Dopplers of all sorts. And for women imaging, being female residents, we definitely get more chances to do breast ultrasound and, you know, obstetric ultrasounds.
All right. So can you guys tell us more about the academic environment in the department? How is the academics in terms of teaching, classes, journal clubs, seminars, practical teaching?
Academics is one of the main reasons I chose this institute, actually, and it's very good, actually. The thing is, we have interdepartmental meets every week. Like, we have a scheduled day for, say, neuro radio meet, and then another scheduled day for a gastro radio meet, and then chest radio. So basically, in these meets, what happens is we have residents of either medicine or chest medicine, for example, presenting the case, and then the radiology resident comes and presents the CT findings or the MR findings. And so basically, during these presentations, there are questions which are asked by the consultants of both departments. So it is a great learning experience for us. So it almost is like an exam, but without the stress of the exam. So it's in a calm environment, and it would probably, this kind of interaction would definitely help out later on, probably. So apart from these interdepartmental meets, we also have proper scheduled teaching classes also. by our consultants, and then apart from that we have seminars that PGs are asked to make and then present. But the majority chunk of learning actually happens on the case wise learning, because like she said, we make the provisional report and then they do the final one. So that is when majority happens. We read up on stuff while making the reports. All of you would already know all of this. Yeah. So.
And also I would like to add, like when we are posted in a particular modality, we get to sit beside the consultant while they are reporting the normal OPDs or, you know, daily scans. So we get to learn a lot. We can freely ask them any question that we want to. They are very much approachable. Even in this time of Corona, we have web-based online lectures which are taken by our consultants. So they are very keen on teaching.
All right. Thank you. Can you guys comment on the hostel facilities, the food, and how is everything like?
Okay, so hostel is provided by the hospital itself. There's a building for the residents, all the resident doctors, and it is 3 to 3.5 kilometers away from the hospital. It is close to the Andheri station. We get auto rickshaws very easily for, you know, coming from hostel to hospital, and there are 4 to 5 residents in one flat, which is like a 2 BHK flat. And also we don't have to pay rent for it. It is provided completely by the hospital. The area is not that good, but most of the time we are in the hospital, which is really good, so it hardly matters. Then regarding the food, well, food, it's never like home food, but yeah, we have a lot of options. For example, we have mezzanine, we have mess, and that provides like a palatable food. But if you really want to have good food, then we have fine dining, we have food court, we have Subway, CCD, Starbucks. So there are a lot of options available. Stipend, we have 50,000 approximately, and that is same as that of any state run hospital.
And do you guys get any kind of house rent allowance or TADA of sorts, or it's just 50,000?
Yeah, it's 50,000.
All right, thank you. Can you comment on support from the department in terms of research and publications? How's the general research environment like for someone who wants to actively do and pursue research?
Yeah, so there is a lot of push given by our consultants for this, because they start off by kind of orienting us to research basically, and then also they have their own published articles. So most of them are already, they know exactly how all of this works, so that way they help us out a lot. So push is given in this respect. So if we do show a little bit of interest, we can get a lot of publishing and all of that done.
Also, Dr. Akhila, I would like to ask you something. Since you are from Bangalore and you come from Karnataka, and this is specifically for our South Indian viewers, because they sometimes have doubt about that. Did you feel any kind of difficulty while working in our hospital, since you have limited knowledge of Hindi and everything? Can you comment
absolutely
on that?
Absolutely not. Honestly, 100% honest, absolutely not. Actually, I didn't have to. So I had a little bit of problem in the initial months in communicating freely in Hindi. So I never faced any issue, because most of them are very warm, very friendly, and be it the technicians, be it the consultants, be it our own seniors and colleagues, it's a great working environment overall. So there was absolutely no problem. Even in the hostel side, no issues. And even the transport, I mean, even the auto wallas, I've never faced any issue.
Also, I think most of the patients know English in our hospital.
Yes, most people know English, and even a lot of people also speak to you in Hindi, but most of it you will be able to manage with just a little bit of Bangalore knowledge, and even if it is not there, it really doesn't matter. You will catch up on that eventually.
All right. And can you guys comment on is there any DM or fellowship in our hospital for radiology?
Yeah, so we have a fellowship in interventional radiology. It is of 2 years, and currently we have 2 postgraduates who are pursuing this.
All right. So I think you guys have been helpful enough to our viewers, and I would really like to thank you. And if if you guys liked our video, kindly like it, and if you want us our team to make more videos like that, kindly comment and hopefully subscribe to our channel.
Thank you.